Alrighty, let's do it again. This time it's called a Turner's Key. So I made it up in Creo and made a drawing actually this time out of it, because this is nice and symmetric. So, got the dimensions. Looking in our bulk stock, I found a chunk of aluminum. I'm going to make this out of a 2x2 piece. So, yeah, I marked it off and let's start cutting. Why not? Proper use of a bandsaw includes making sure your hand is in direct line of the blade. Also, only use one hand. If you can use your foot, that's even better. Like Final Destination.
So one thing to notice is that this little ridge that I can easily feel and grab a fingernail on, that should be there. So that means the table, with respect to the head is not aligned. This one, because it's in that direction, means that this thing is pivoting either forward or backwards. So I need to tram that head before I go any further. I got a couple holes there that I unfortunately need to get rid of. That means I need to make one extra cut. So I made my lines, which you can't see for crap. It's so shiny. Oh, there we go. So in order to tram the head of the Bridgeport, you need a tramming indexer. I don't know what they're called, but they cost a lot of money, but instead I just made one. So I just took a dowel and shoved it through this piece of aluminum and then cut a little slot down there so I can clamp on a dial indicator And sure, if that's not 90 up there and that's not 90, it doesn't matter, because as long as it's rigid, it's good. And it's rigid, so, yeah. So currently I successfully trammed the head, but it was kind of weird. I'm pretty sure that the table that I trammed to before is not really aligned with the vise, or I should say the vise is not the table. So the vise screwed up. It probably means some shimming on this rotating part. Either way, I went like that. I dropped it down to the stop. It is at zero. And now, bring it up. Unfortunately, the tram head's a little small. But hey, it works, right? If it ain't work, it ain't stupid, or whatever. And I go down and exactly zero again. So that means the head this direction is good. Okay, so I trammed the head on both X and Y direction. Now I put the square stock in there, and now I'm gonna face it.
I got a nice 2-ish by 2-ish cube. It's not to the final dimension, but I will do that soon. Not right now. It is Earth Day, and I'm gonna go pick up trash, and then I'm gonna get dilly bars. Tomorrow's my birthday, so you know, what is that thing? Whatever, I'm done. And I set it to like 2.06, maybe put like 60 thou on it, and then I did three of the sides, marked them. As you can see, the blue little lines there. And then I went around after setting the final one to 2 inches depth, and now I'm cleaning up the sides that aren't marked. So that means it'll be a 2x2x2. By 2 cube. So that's done. Next is to figure out a way to put a parallel or some sort of stopper so I don't have to keep on locating where the middle of this is, and then I'll be doing some drilling and boring and all that stuff. Alright, I figured out my stop. I use that long vise grip thing again, and then put a parallel on the edge and clamped it down really hard, so no matter what, I will slide it in. It up there as flush as me, and it'll be locked down, and that'll be my centering. Cube, I got some blue layout fluid, so now I can make everything look like click spring. So I marked off all of the centers just in case it's not a perfect cube, but I promise it is. Now I'm going to use another piece of tooling next. I'm super excited about this. Coaxial indicator. It uses all these different tips for finding centers by wiggling in the mill when it's on, and I'm going to hopefully be able to use this point to locate off of all those dimples I just made. And then I'll be able to get this thing super centered. Now, this is just more for fun. I will use this clamp, like I showed before, parallel on the side, and just use that as a centering guess. But, you know, I gotta learn how to use this, right? Why not? So the whole point of the coaxial indicator is that when I put it to that center punch, focus, you, the coaxial indicator will move more and more the more it's off center. Dial in the X and Y where that thing barely moves. We're kind of sweet spot there. So I mean, that's within a thou, and that's pretty accurate. And to what I already said, it I was 0.01 millimeters off. So that's probably good enough for me.
That'll do ya.
Break on through to the other side. you, that right there is a nice hole. Satisfying thing about a brand new hole drilled is, oh yeah, it just feels good. It's actually working. So I accidentally drilled this hole to be just a half an inch, while my drawing, which is right next to me, says 3/4 inch. So I screwed that up, but I just made it so it's a super small, thin wall, which actually looks pretty good. So yeah, that's the whole scope of it.
Whistling, that's when you know it's good. Yes, whistling.